Welcome to the happy hour Wednesday. It's 5 o'clock. It means it's happy hour time. Welcome to the show. If it's your first time, my name is Alan Chamo. I'm your host. I also happen to be a mentalist, which is like a magician with some mental issues. And we are here every Wednesday at 5 p.m. And today we are also going live on YouTube and Facebook at the same time. So if you're on YouTube right now, say hello. You can put a comment and you can still interact with us. But it's more fun to be on Zoom. Let's see everybody here on Zoom. Say hello. Very good. We have great guests. And this is a live show. This is the new reality of theater, all right? So welcome, welcome. So if you're joining on YouTube or Facebook, you can join us next week. We'll put the link later on over there and you can register and be part of the show because this is all about audience participation. And every week, it's not only me, but I have with me an amazing entertainer. He joins us from Las Vegas. With us here, Ryan Ahern. Ryan, what's up?
How you doing, Alan? Good evening to you and everybody on Facebook and Zoom and all those different formats. How's everything going, Alan?
Good, great. You know, I had we had a good week. Mika is back to school for a day, and then they closed the school because apparently there's a kid, you know, that maybe has COVID. I don't know. But anyway, so she's back home for another 10 days now.
Okay. Yes. All right.
That's it. The new reality.
You can work on your home teaching skills, I guess.
Yeah, exactly.
Mentalism a required class in your household, I wonder?
Excuse me?
Is mentalism a required class at the Chamo household?
I cannot perform mentalism on my girl. Just doesn't work. Yeah, it just doesn't work. They perform mentalism on me. They kind of hypnotize me.
I talk about mind control. Sure.
Mind control. She comes to me and is like, Daddy, please. And it's like, okay, all right. So that's how it works with us. Awesome. Well, today we have a great show. And I know that I say this every show, but today I really mean it.
But it's true every week is the point. It's true every
week. Yes, and that's the reason why so many of you are coming back to Zoom and joining us. So thank you very much. And thank you for your support, by the way. Those of you, you know, the show, you don't have to chip in. The show is absolutely free. It's a service that we provide for, you know, when it started COVID back in September, we started doing this, Ryan, remember?
Yes, I do.
To help the community, those that cannot go out to the theater and would like to enjoy some live entertainment. And that's what we've been doing every week since then. I think we canceled only once. So very proud of you, Ryan, for joining and continuing doing this.
Well, thank you very much. You know, it's 2 o'clock over here in Las Vegas. So this isn't exactly happy hour over here just yet. But as long as you're doing okay on the East Coast, that's all that matters.
Yeah. And by the way, you reminded me. And I will tell you later during the show, but next week is going to be the first time that we are going to do the show at 7 p.m. Eastern time. 7 p.m. Oh, really? I know. So please put it in your calendar. It's going to be 7, not 5. It's just that I have a gig. Hey, I have to work. I have a gig and I just couldn't say no. And
well,
that's what it is.
You,
that's
the reality. Friend. All right.
Yeah. So 7 o'clock for next week. Hey, so let's start the show. I prepared something very fun and I will need some audience participation. And this is a big part of why you should join us on Zoom and not just watch it on YouTube. But if you're watching the rerun, you can still enjoy it and maybe you can even participate in this part. So I will need, Ryan, so we'll see you later. Also, we have the game. We have an incredible entertainer. We have a magician today. We have a month of magicians, but everybody loves magicians, so... it's all good. So let me jump in and do this. I need help and I would love to get assistance from some people here. So I will just call on a few. For example, we have Dagmari. Am I saying your name correct? Hi, how are you? Can you please unmute yourself? Hello. Oh, you just muted yourself, but... I'm trying to unmute you and you're unmuting yourself at the same time, so it's kind of doing it double, you know? How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Thank you for joining. It's the first time I see you here, so I would guess it's your first time on the show.
It is my first time, and I have family that I invited to. I'm in New York, and I have family in Orlando and Miami, and they're here. So it's an activity that we picked to do together today.
Oh, wonderful. So maybe I can see the rest of your family. Maybe you guys can go like this and say hello so I can see you. So we have, there we go, Carmen Luisa. Carmen Luisa, how are you doing? Can you unmute yourself as well? We're going to do it. It's a family show, so we're going to add more people here. Oh, I see myself three times. All right, there we go. There you go. Maria Luisa, Carmen Luisa, sorry.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi, everything is good so far.
And you're joining from Orlando?
No, we are in Fort Lauderdale.
Ah, okay, close to me. I'm in Miami, so very, very close. Yeah. All right, so who's the third of the family there? We have anybody else from the family? Go like this.
Yeah, Mommy.
Mommy. Hi. Where's Mommy? Mommy's hiding. Ah, there you go. Mommy is Marilexi, yes?
Yeah.
Marilexi. Very good, Marilexi. Can you join us as well? Hello, Marilexi. Thank you for joining us as well.
Yes. How are you?
Good, very good. All right. So we're going to try and do something here with the three girls from the family, which is the first for me as well. And the idea here, we're going to do some kind of, you can call it lie detector. But part of what I do is I use body language, facial expressions, tone of voice, different things to try and detect certain things. Okay. So to do this, it's going to be like a game that you played when you were kids. So what I want you to do is go ahead and grab a small object, something you can hide inside your fist. It can be a coin, a piece of paper, anything that you have around you. Go ahead, do it now, quickly. Okay? So, very good. There you go. Dagmarie, she's looking around the house. Carmen Luisa, are you ready? You have something? Okay, very good. Marilexi, you have something? Okay.
Yes.
You're holding something big in your hand, no? Let's see. What is that? Can you put it up so we can see it?
Drink.
Okay. Drink? Okay, drink. It's a happy hour. You should drink. All right. So for those of you on YouTube, let me see if I can also share everything here. I will try this. It might look a little weird. Let's see. Oh, we see a little triple there. All right, let's give it a try. That doesn't look good enough. All right, so ladies, you ready? You have an object, go ahead and hide it in one of your hands. Don't tell me which hand. Okay? And I will ask you a question, very simple question, and you can either lie to me or tell me the truth, and I will try to detect what is it you're doing. But go ahead and first of all, unmute yourself so you don't have to touch anything after that. So go ahead, Carmen Luisa, you are muted, and Dagmarie, you are also muted. So if you can unmute yourself. There you go. Carmen Luisa, you can unmute yourself. There you go, you are muted. Very good, perfect. So let's start. Go ahead and hide the object in one of your hands. You know, it's like the game when you put an object behind your back in one of your hands, you go like this, and then the other person needs to try and figure out in which hand you're holding the object. That's what we're going to play right now, all right? So go ahead, hide the object in one of your hands. Now, Marie, you don't have to put it behind your back because we have a camera and I cannot see under the camera, so don't worry about it.
I'm very honest, yes.
I like it. All right, so this is the game where you don't have to be very honest. It's a game where you are allowed to lie. All right, so let's start. Carmen Luisa, you have the object in one of your hands? Okay.
Yes.
So let me ask you a quick question, and let me put you so everybody can see you as well here. Hold on a second. Perfect, there you go. So people also on YouTube can see you. Is the object in your right hand? Remember, you can lie or say the truth.
No.
No, okay. And look at her, she's no, like this, she went like this, a little, okay. Yeah, by the way, Marilexi, you're the mother, so you should know when your daughters are lying, no?
Yeah.
Tú sabes si mienten o dicen la verdad, no? You just look at them and you know, yeah.
I know. No.
Okay. Yeah. Well, we're going to do a little Spanglish, as you notice here. Okay. So, all right. So, Carmen Luisa, you said no. All right. I'm not sure about you. Marilexi, remember, you can lie. Puedes mentir si quieres. Is the object in your right hand?
Yes.
Okay. Wow, don't play poker with Marilexi. She is tough. Okay. All right. Dagmarie, am I saying your name correct? Dagmarie?
Yeah, everyone say it like they like, so it's fun.
Ah, like what?
Like they like. People call me as they like, so it's fun.
I would like to call you the way your name is.
So, yeah, Dagmarie is fine. Dagmarie.
Dagmarie. Okay. Dagmarie, same question to you. Is the object in your right hand?
No.
She did not hesitate. And she went with a little... Okay. All right. So let's go to a second round. Second round is this. Go ahead, all of you, and you can switch hands if you want, or you can leave the object in the same hand. It's your choice. Do it now. Go ahead. Puedes cambiar mano o dejar la misma mano. Just a quick translation, just in case. All right. Very good. Ready? I will ask you now a different question, but it's going to be the same question for all of you, and I will tell you the question ahead of time. So I want you to think about the answer ahead of time. Ready? So the question will be, did you switch hands? Now, it's very important that if you lie to me the first time, you have to lie again. Si mentiste la primera ronda, tienes que mentir otra vez. Okay? And if you said the truth the first round, you have to be truthful again. All right? So continue with the same line that you started. Okay? So the question is, did you switch hands? That's the question. So, Carmen Luisa, did you switch hands?
Yes.
You always blink when you answer. It's... Okay. And Dagmarie is laughing. She knows something about you, obviously, that we don't. Okay. Let me ask you one more question because I'm not sure about you. And again, if you lied to me, you have to continue lying. The question would be, do you own a pet?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Not sure about you. Let's see here with the mother. Marilexi, the question is the same question. La pregunta es la misma, okay? Did you switch hands?
Yes.
Okay. Again, not sure about you. Let me ask you another question. What do you do for a living?
I live in Orlando, Florida.
Okay, but what do you, ¿qué haces en tu, de qué trabajas? What do you do for a living?
The computer system.
Okay, computer system. All right, good. And Dagmarie, the same question to you. Did you switch hands? Look at her, she's always like, You are very like this, huh? Are you a teacher?
I'm not a teacher, no. I'm a fitness instructor, so yeah, kind of.
Okay, that will explain. Okay, so I think I got it. And again, what I do is not exact science. I hope that everybody understood the instructions and continue with the same line as the first round. Marilexi, I'm not sure about you. Dagmarie, I will say which hand I think you have the object. When I say the hand, lift that hand and show everybody if the object is there, okay? So in your case, I think the object is in your left hand.
Yay.
Very good. We got it. Left hand. Awesome. Awesome. Good job. Thank you so much. Let's see here. Marilexi, I think that your object is in your left hand as well. I'm not sure about you, but it's in your left hand. Yes? Okay. Show. Yeah. 2 out of 2. I'm getting the family here. Carmen Luisa, the one that always blinks when she answers. In your case, I think the object is your right hand. 3 out of 3. Yes, deserves an applause.
All right.
Hey, ladies, thank you so much. You are wonderful. You have great minds. And please come again to the show next week, okay? As a family, we would love to have you every week here, all right? And by the way, and if you ever miss a show and you want to see it, we are posting all the shows on YouTube, so you can always go there and check it out. Again, YouTube, you can put Alan Chamo, and you should find, or Happy Hour with Alan Chamo, and you should be able to find it. By the way, which reminds me, here's our logo. Oh, there we go. All right, and now we're coming to a very important part of the show, part where, that you've been waiting for. We have a very special guest today. I will not do a long introduction because he has a very special introduction. So he's a great magician. He's from Orlando. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the virtual stage, Nathan Coe Marsh.
One of the stars from the Penn and Teller TV series.
Now he has performed all over this world.
He's amazed crowds with mind-blowing stunts.
So dynamic.
Ooh. He's groundbreaking.
I don't know how you did that.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Nathan Coe Marsh.
So a overly dramatic opening bit just for you guys. It is such a privilege to be here, Alan. This is so cool what you've created. Hey guys, if you can hear me, wave your hands. Wave your awesome rock on. I see a couple of you, I can't see waving your hands because you don't have your cameras on. And that is cool, that's fine. Just know that what's great about this kind of medium is that it's like a show where I can see you, you can see me, we're here in the moment right now, not just watching Netflix. So I'd love you to turn those on, or otherwise we can all just sit and wonder what ungodly deeds are happening behind your black screens. Crazy, strange, weird things. So my name is Nathan Coe Marsh. I'm coming to you today from Orlando, Florida. I know we have a couple other Floridians here as well. And you know us for our theme parks, lands of imagination, wonder, $17 sodas, and chafed inner thighs. But that's not what we're here to talk about, guys. We're going to start off with something I'm calling Here's the deal, gang. So the guy, he's got the, he's basically, this is a scam. It's an ancient scam. The guy, he's got three bits of white cardboard that he shows you. And the objective, gang, is to watch those as closely as you can and follow this guy. That's the money card. This is the sugar. It's like a guessing game, right? This is the sugar. This is the honey. This is the one that makes you money. Sometimes it creeps, sometimes it crawls. Sometimes it's not where you think at all. Watch closely. Did you guys see it go here? Did you guys see it go here? I'm only trying to help. I'm just trying to be helpful, guys. I promise. I swear. Here's the deal. It is all about focus. It's about focusing the entirety of your attention on that red X there, forgetting completely about these guys. Now, some guys, and I won't name names, but some people bet down here. They're disappointed. And it ain't over here, because we always keep it down here. Now, Imagine for a second, ladies and gentlemen, you're 16 years old. You're walking down the Midway, enjoying a chocolate ice cream cone. Your wallet is heavy from the weight of the first paycheck from the first summer job that you've just deposited. And as you walk down, enjoying that chocolate ice cream, there in the distance, right at the edge of the Midway, near the woods, you see a little crowd. And in the middle of that crowd is the guy. He's got gray mutton chops, silver hair there, picking his teeth with a knife between rounds. He's got a diamond ring on his finger. And as you watch, you're following exactly where that money card is, right? You're seeing exactly where it's going. These people around you must be some dumb country bumpkins because they keep losing. You're getting it right, they're getting it wrong. So you decide to venture $1, you decide to bet. But when you try to bet, somebody else bets $5, and the guy says he only takes the highest bet. You try to bet 10, somebody bets 20. And as you're lost in the moment, you feel a little bit of that melted chocolate ice cream drip down, hits the base of your flesh. That's when I had an idea. I was gonna out-hustle the hustle. This, friends, will, this adorable puppy sticker right here, that will represent for dramatic purposes, that will play the part of that little dab of melted chocolate ice cream. The guy, as I had the idea, I reached in, I grabbed that wad full of bills from that first summer paycheck from that first summer job. And as I went to set them on the table, I felt the bills fluttering in the July breeze. As I went to lay them down, the guy took that thick finger and he was about to, right as he was about to pin those bills down, I let go. And when he turned around to grab those bills, I took just a dab of that melted chocolate ice cream and just kind of rubbed right there. Now I'm exaggerating for you, friends, because you're here on camera and it'd be hard to see just a little bit, but it was very subtle. You had to know it was there, to know it was there. You dig what I'm saying? So the guy proceeded, not quite knowing, he went through the stuff about this is the sugar. This is the honey. This is the one that makes you money. I said, I don't know what got into me. I grabbed that knife. I said, freeze right there, buddy. I know for a fact that that ain't it and that ain't it. Pay up, old man. He looked at me and he said, kid, don't you ever mess with my cards. It'll only confuse you. And then he turned over one I had just touched, and that was the winner. And that's when I learned that a fool and his money were lucky to get together in the first place. All right, gang. Coin and a mirror, a little bit of glass. Watch closely. So what you are looking at here will give you an even better, there we go, professional show business in the 21st century. We'll give you an even better view there. We'll bring down the volume on that beautiful piano music there. So what you're looking at here, gang, three coins, they're about 12 inches off the surface of the table. They are resting on a 9/8 inch piece of glass, which itself is resting on some wine glasses. The goal is to get the coins from this side to that side without actually like smacking them straight through. Below, above. Should emphasize here, it is simply a piece of glass resting on four wine glasses. Hello, hello, above. Little penetration straight through, and some of that spontaneous applause. That's in Doug. All right, there we go. Well, hey, gang, good to see you guys. Let me ask this as I survey across. Actually, before I ask this, we're closing in on the big grand finale of this little taste. If you guys are enjoying this, head on over to NathanComarsh.com. We got some more details, shows, fun stuff, all that good stuff. But we're going to share one final thing with you. Something that can only be described as
inconceivable.
I'm going to invite, who's got, raise your hand. I can only see a few of you at this moment, but who's got, wave your hands if you've got a deck of cards that's near you somewhere in the house. Maybe it's in a drawer. Maybe it's in Vi. Take a moment. Let me look through. Marie might, and let me grab, let's see. Oh, did I see Lynn? Did you? Oh, Marie. Yeah, that'd be perfect, Marie. I think you're going to be amazing for this. Marie, I'm going to bring you in as we come through here. And hey, she appeared. Welcome. How are you? Oh, there she is. There she is. It's the mirror. Marie, good to see you. If you want to unmute yourself, how are you doing this afternoon?
Yes, I'm doing fine. Thank you. I was really looking forward to seeing you.
Oh, I appreciate that. Oh, thank you so much. Cool, cool. I'm glad you had the chance to. Marie, let me ask you this. So you have a deck of cards near you?
It's not far. Let me get
it. It's not far. Okay, she's going to go on an epic journey for it. As Marie does, I'm going to let you guys in on a little something. What makes this inconceivable, as it were, is that you're the first audience to experience this. This is like the ants have seen this. Oh, she's got, this is a, oh, cool, cool. She found them. That's awesome. That's fantastic, Marie. Good to see you. Cool, cool. Well, this is, you got some cards. Cool. I don't know if it's a full deck or not, Marie. I'm going to invite you, which is fine. It's okay if it's not. But these aren't like trick cards, right? Because they'll think that maybe, you know, it's trick magic cards. You would show everybody, Marie. Go ahead and show them. Yeah, you got it. Perfect, Marie. Yeah, good, good, good. Excellent, Marie. And as we go through there, cool. And let me ask you this. This is fun, brand new. We'll ask you this, Marie. I'm going to invite you to, can you tilt your camera down? Is that possible? Is it like on a laptop or something? We're asking Marie to do a lot of manual labor here, but we're going to unmute you too, Marie. I know our tech ninjas who are amazing here, Alan. I just want to compliment the entire operation you have. They're incredible. Marie, go ahead and lower the camera down for us. Oh, you're good. You're fine. But I'm going to invite you to bring the camera down. You know how you tilt it like if it's on a laptop? Perfect. And is there like a little table surface there under you, Marie?
Yes.
There it is. Cool. Go ahead and tilt it down. This will be easier for you if it's on the table. I promise, Marie. I promise. And here's what we're going to do. I'll give you a good view too, Marie. Yeah, go ahead and tilt it down so like we can see on the table. Perfect. You can tilt. Yeah, just kind of tilt the camera down, Marie.
I don't know how to do that.
Oh, no problem. No problem. Oh, there you go. There you go. You're almost there. Almost there. Perfect. Perfect. You're doing great, Marie.
Okay.
That's what we're going to do. You're amazing. You're incredible. I appreciate all the manual labor you're doing here for this magic. It's going to be great. Marie, I'm going to invite you to pick the cards up in your hand. Excellent. And what you're going to do, Marie, is onto the table, one by one, you're going to deal those cards face up, stopping whenever you would like, Marie. It's entirely up to you. Perfect. Actually, you know what? My apologies, Marie. My apologies. I just realized something as you're doing that. Maybe I can be like counting the cards and seeing how many. So take the ones you just dealt, put them back on top. And let's do this. Right there. That's perfect. And instead of that, Marie, I'm going to invite you to lift up a small portion of cards.
Okay.
Excellent. Turn them over and put them back on top. Beautifully done, Marie. In fact, this time, I'm going to invite you to go even further, Marie. Reach deeper into the deck. Lift up even more cards. And then you'll turn those over. Awesome. And put them back. And turn them all the way over and put them back on top. Beautifully done, Marie. Cool, cool, cool. And let's review, shall we, Marie? I didn't like pay you $50 and tell you where to cut those, right? And you don't. Now, if you had dealt down, I might have known the number of cards where that cut happened. But I can't even know that this way. And you don't even know that this way. Marie, here's what I'd like you to do. We've created this awful mess of your cards. I'd like you to go through the face-up cards, and the spot that you cut at is that first face-down card, Marie. I'd like you to, you can just spread them and take that first face-down card. Don't look at it. Don't let anybody in the room see it. So it's the first face-down one. It's the one that's got the cactus showing. Perfect. And Marie, if you would take that, hold it against yourself like it's a precious secret there, Marie. And you don't know what that card is, right?
Do I know? I don't know what it is.
You don't know what it is? Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. So here's what we're going to do, Marie. If I were to shuffle the cards right here at this moment in my hands on my side of the screen, that might be kind of suspicious. So we've got a system here for shuffling these cards that's going to be very, very random. And we have a magic wand, Marie, a very eccentric magic wand.
Here we go,
Marie. Just hold it close to yourself. You don't even know what that card is. Here we go, guys. Let's see what we can do. I have one card here on the tip of my blade that the knife found, Marie. The card that my knife found is the Nine of Diamonds. Marie doesn't even know what this card is. Marie, if you want to tilt the camera up for us, just kind of tilt the perfect so we can see your beautiful face. And Marie, for the very first time, what is the card that you've been holding against yourself?
Oh my God. Oh my God, a Nine of Diamonds. That is amazing. Wow.
Thank you so much, Marie. You were incredible. Guys, give her the waving hand. We'll give her the
Look at that. I was awesome. Just in the magic frame.
Oh, I appreciate it. Oh, there they are. There they are. That's obnoxious. That's so pretentious. Might bring up the screen of you guys. Hey, it has been a genuine pleasure sharing some of my time with you guys. I hope you guys had as much fun with me as I did with you. Have a great rest of the happy hour. I'm going to turn it over to our amazing host, Alan.
Thank you. Wow, let's give him a hand. That was pretty cool. Thank you, Nate. Thank you. That was fun. Hey, every week we have a different guest, and we really have top of the line entertainers beside Ryan, of course, that is really amazing and is with us every single week. But we have a guest every week joining us. And this time it was Nathan Coe Marsh, and we are so happy to have you. Actually, Nate, please stay with us because we have a game that we're playing. So if it's your first time, we play every week two lies and a truth. So let me bring Ryan. Are you still with me over there?
Yeah, I'm here, Alan. Can you hear me? I think I'm muted though.
There you go. No, we can see you. We can hear you. Perfect. Can everybody hear Ryan? Go like this. Yes. Perfect. All right. So very exciting. We want to play this game. It's called Two Lies and a Truth. Let me add you over here as well with us. Perfect. So here's how, Ryan, would you like to tell our audience what the rules of the game?
Yeah, so Two Lies and a Truth, also known as the Liars Club, is a wonderfully popular game where you are give us a word, a very crazy word, a very unknown word, and each of us is going to give you a definition of that word, and only one of us is telling the truth, and the other two, well, they're full of it. So you get to vote and choose who is telling the truth. Now, there's no Googling, there's no asking your neighbor. It's all in your mind. So,
okay. So the word, every week we have a different letter. So we are now up to the letter N as Nancy.
Wow.
And the word today is narrowback.
Narrowback. Yes.
So as always, Ryan, you go first.
Okay. Well, I happen to know this word very well because my dad called me this growing up many a time. And for those of you who don't know, a narrowback is one who does not engage in physical labor. And now I tend to work with my mind more. I spend a lot of hours at the piano, of course, but you know, out there digging and sweeping and things, not my thing. So a narrowback in essence is somebody who doesn't engage in physical labor for one reason or another.
All right, so one who does not engage in manual labor, that would be your definition. So I guess that I'm a narrow back as well. I mean, I do some manual labor, but not as my job, you know? Right. I mean, unless mentalism is maybe defined like this. All right. Thank you for your definition, which is
totally
complete lie.
What?
It's
okay. Complete. How about you? What say you, my friend?
Oh, yeah. So this is actually, and it makes sense. A narrowback is it's a bird from South America. Actually, you can find it in Peru, in the south of Peru, and in north of Chile. And it's called narrowback because it doesn't really have a narrow back compared to the body, but it has a different color in the back that goes like this. So it looks like it has like big shoulders, and then the back looks very narrow. But it's more of an optical illusion, because you see it from far and you think that the bird looks like this, but in reality it's not like this. It's just the color gives you that illusion, and it's what's called narrow back in the Aboriginal language, and it was translated from there to English, and it's narrow back, and that's the real meaning of what narrow back means. Okay, so it's a South American bird. So Nate, would you like to
Yeah, you guys are you guys are very creative, but I'll let our audience in on the actual definition of a narrowback. A narrowback is somebody who doesn't care about anything, and this goes back to if we have. I grew up watching football. If you guys have any sports fans who are fans of the history of the game, 1965, Notre Dame versus Purdue in the snow. Their fullback William Robinson. Is blocking. The running back comes up behind him, gets stripped. The ball goes on the ground. Robinson, the fullback, grabs the ball, runs, and he's so excited as he scores in the wrong end zone. And the fact that the fullback was actually quite narrow led people to think of this as first somebody who isn't very bright, but eventually it got a more precise, narrow definition to somebody who doesn't care about anything. So that's the story on narrowback.
So basically your definition, which would be C, is one who doesn't care about anything.
Somebody who doesn't care about anything. They're just so caught up in everything else that... Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm not sure I believe it. So those of you who are joining on YouTube and Facebook, you can still put a comment and we can still bring it in. Like we have here Omar that joins us on Facebook, which is also, a musician. He says, waha. Mm-hmm. So you can also put whatever you think the word is, okay, on Facebook or on YouTube. We'll post it here. But if you join us on Zoom, you get to actually vote. So let's put the poll up and let's see here. Where is the poll? There we go. And launch the poll. There we go. Everybody go ahead and vote. This is your moment. Yes. So for those of you who cannot see Nate, he says that it's one who doesn't care about anything. I say it's a South American bird. And Ryan says one who does not engage in manual labor. By the way, if you notice, labor is spelled labor like this on the screen, but on Zoom, it's spelled like the UK version. So we have a little variety for everybody. So let's see here.
Very nice.
Yeah. So we have 29 out of 40 that voted. So please go ahead, vote. You should see it on your screen. Just click it, you know, get off the sofa and go over there and just click. So, because your vote really counts here. So up until now, wow, a lot of people believe me, obviously, because I'm a trustworthy individual. Nate, not many people believe you. I mean, and you know, your spiel sounded pretty convincing to me, but hey, apparently this audience knows better. So we have 36 out of 40. I think we're gonna let me see, do we have anybody okay on Facebook, YouTube? They just don't care, they're gonna watch the rerun. All right, so it's done. We had 36 people out of 40, 90% vote. That's pretty good. So let's end the poll and share with you the results. So according to the audience here, and I don't know if I can bring it in, let me see if it's possible. No. Okay, so according to our audience, I won. 15 people voted for me.
Okay, really?
South American bird. Yeah, listen, it makes sense. 13 people voted for you. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Ryan. And only 8 voted for Nate. Oh, wah, 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 wah. Okay.
Pretty close.
Yeah, well, no, not close between us, but Nate is way behind. Nate, yeah. if it counts, you know, you were very, very convincing to me. If I wouldn't know what's the meaning, I would maybe vote for you, okay? So the actual meaning, the person that is telling the truth, on the count of 3, the person that is telling the truth, go ahead and raise your hand. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Ah, got your narrow backs out there.
Yes,
very good. Yes. One who doesn't do manual labor, huh? All right, Alan. Yes. That's a good word today. I wonder where that word actually came from.
It came from a dictionary. Well, I don't know all these words. So, Ryan, you got everybody. And normally we have such a very smart audience. And normally they get it. Normally they're on top of it. But today we manage. You know what, but hey, it's just that I was very convincing. That's what it was. So,
well, that's usually what it is. In fact, I'd like to know how many people guessed that, or how many people actually really knew the definition of that word. Maybe in the comments if you like it.
It's always fun. So go ahead, put it in the comment if you voted for that word because you actually knew that word. We would love to know if you actually knew that word or you just guessed.
Believe.
Okay. Me. Just believed Ryan. So go ahead and put it in the chat. We would love to know, because sometimes after the show I get somebody, you know, emailing me and saying, hey, you know, I knew that word because this half means this and that half means that, and it makes sense, which I didn't know about it. But go ahead, you can put it in the chat. Hey, Nate, thank you so much for participating. Appreciate it. See you next time. And we put your website also in the chat so you guys can look him up. Great, great work. I appreciate it. All right. And Ryan, we're coming to the fun part of the show. But before that, I want to remind everybody, next week, it's 7 p.m. Eastern time. 7 p.m. Eastern time. We have a great magician next week. His name is Chris Michael. A young magician, very, very good. Okay, I always bring really, really good.
You know all the good people, Alan. I don't know. Do you have a secret society going on where you can pool these people from? Because you bring in some great talent.
Yes, right. It's the Harry Potter school. I'm bringing them from there.
Nice.
What's the name of that school? Hogwarts?
Yeah, the Hogwarts.
Okay. So next week, 7 p.m., please register. We put the link on the chat so you can check it out over there. We will also put it on Facebook, YouTube. So if you're watching the rerun on YouTube and you would love to participate, actually be part of the audience with the cool people on Zoom live, you can join us. You just need to register and it's free. So thank you. And thank you for all of you that chip in and help the show to continue. You know, even if it's $5, we really appreciate it. You don't have to, but every single little thing helps, you know, to have, you know, all this production. It is a production. Ryan is in a theater in Las Vegas. I'm in a studio here in Miami, and we're trying to pull everything together here and make a show. And Ryan, this is the most exciting part of the show.
Is it now?
To hear you play. Yes.
Well, you're very kind to say that. Very cool. Well, you know, I wanted to start off tonight with a song. This is the first song that I ever learned. And I think this song, as for a lot of people, really motivated people to want to learn the piano. And it's a very famous TV theme song from a cartoon back in the day called Charlie Brown. I know we got some fans out there of Charlie Brown and Peanuts. So this is a song called The Peanuts Theme from Charlie Brown. Here we go. Charlie Brown for you guys. You know, I want to take you down to South America, and there's a wonderful song that I had the pleasure of recording recently. It's called La Bikina, for all you South American fans. Some wonderful music coming out of that part of the world. I know it's not a song that everybody knows, you know, on a popular level, but I do hope you enjoy the beauty of it. Here we go. Thank you. Thank you very much. I want to leave you tonight with a great Broadway song from Andrew Lloyd Webber. We had some requests for Andrew Lloyd Webber, and this is another one of my favorites. This is from the movie. It's also a movie. It's also Broadway, of course, called Cats. It's a very famous song called Memory. Thank you very much, Alan. Appreciate everything.
All right, Ryan, that was awesome. That was awesome. Thank you so much. Fun to hear you play. And you know what? I just want to read one quick comment because I know that you cannot see the chat. So Lucy says, love the Peanut song. It's always fun to watch you play and listen to your wonderful piano playing. Oh. You're so talented. Thank you for sharing your talent with us.
Thank you very much, Lucy. That means everything to me. Appreciate that. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, I think you froze over there, but we can still hear you. And I guess that's a little bit of the challenge of this communication. So we can still hear you. So thank you, everybody, for joining us. Please join us next week, 7 p.m. Register. You have the link right there. Until next week, Ryan, go ahead. Take it away.
All right, buddy. Thank you.